In the hamlet known as Fieldtown, on an evening long ago, in 1777, cloaked in January snow, the tale is told of love and death where fact and fiction blend. It's up to you to seek the truth and see where it may end. John Parker owned the tavern where his fare and draft were sold. He had a daughter, Phyllis, perhaps 16 years old. Her fiancé, Dr. Byram, was a boarder at their inn. The stage was set for tragedy as this ghostly tale begins. General Wayne came up from Princeton seeking shelter in the night. He walked into the tavern, bathed in firelight. Dr. Byram saw the general and retired to his room. And the tavern lay in stillness and the ever-growing gloom. Early light of morning found Byram gone away. No one thought it strange until General Wayne exclaimed, "My notes from General Washington are gone without a doubt." Soon all thoughts turned to the doctor and his whereabouts. It's been said the Parker Tavern's firesides are haunted through the open doors. The phantom Phyllis Parker flits and glides with feet that make no sound upon the floors. Wayne was shown a likeness of the doctor by and by. He said, "His name's not Byram, it's Aaron Wilde, a British spy." Soon soldiers were assembled and all were reconciled to search the town and the countryside and capture Aaron Wilde. Well, they caught him at a crossroad down yonder half a mile. He had the stolen papers, so they held a speedy trial. Wilde's last request to Parker was to ride, "Please bury me." And 30 minutes later, Wilde was hanging from a tree. The soldiers cut his body down and nailed it in a box. Parker kept things quiet just to spare Phyllis the shock. Soldiers brought the coffin to the tavern's taproom floor and left it overnight, awaiting burial in the morn. It's been said the Parker Tavern's firesides are haunted and through the open doors. The phantom Phyllis Parker flits and glides with feet that make no sound upon the floor. Thank you. Meanwhile, naive Phyllis waited for her love to show. She asked about where Byron was, but no one seemed to know. And curious about what lay upon the taproom floor, when all had gone to sleep, she crept outside her bedroom door. In the silence after midnight, down the stairway Phyllis slid. She pried the nails, cracked the wood, and split the coffin lid. And horrified to gaze upon her lover lying dead. Well, she shrieked and screamed and went insane. At least that's what's been said. Since then, many folks have seen a woman's ghostly form appearing in the halls and rooms, seeming so forlorn. It's assumed the ghost of Phyllis Parker does not rest in peace. But some say there are other souls that yearn to be released. It's been said the Parker Tavern's firesides are haunted, and through the open doors the phantom Phyllis Parker flits and glides. The feet that make no sound upon the